appreciate the deep concern that he feels for the people in the region, and you could hear on his speech today how his frustration. I trust also that we, through the meeting, that the president sensed the sadness and the sorrow that we feel for this tragic accident that should never have happened. BP, we have always met our obligations and responsibilities, and we have made clear from the first moment of this tragedy that we will live up to all our legitimate responsibilities. We have agreed today with the president a framework that should assure the American people that we mean what we say. We will look after the people affected, and we will repair the damage to this region, the environmental damage to this region and to the economy. We are announcing today, as you heard from the president, a $20 billion commitment to make sure that all proper claims are handled swiftly and fairly. We have also announced an independent adjudicator that makes sure that the right people will get the right money at the right time. The BP board has today decided that we will not pay any further dividends this year. We made it clear to the president that words are not enough. We understand that we will and we should be judged by our actions. What has been clear today is that this administration and our company are fully aligned in our interest of closing this well, cleaning the beaches, and care for those that are affected. Finally, I would like to take this opportunity to apologize to the American people on behalf of all the employees in BP, many of whom are living on the Gulf Coast. And I do thank you for the patience that you have in this difficult time. Through our actions and commitments, we hope that we over long term, that we will regain the trust that you have in us. Thanks a lot. And I will take a couple of questions.
Are you going to respond to Steve Andrade? I want to ask you, did BP take safety shortcuts in all the deep water wells?
We are going through a series of investigations, and we in the board, we will do our own independent investigation where we will scrutinize everything that we do to make sure that we understand the root cause of this tragic accident, because it shouldn't happen. I have no further comments on that.
That was a long meeting. What were the sticking points? What were the points of disagreement that had to be resolved? And are you concerned about illegitimate payments?
I think it was a very constructive meeting, and it is a meeting that includes many, many different parts, and it is important to get all the language right. But the determination and the ambition to get through this was clear from the beginning.
How long did you spend with the president himself?
I spent a fair amount of time, and I must say that he's frustrated because he cares about the small people, and we care about the small people. I hear comments sometimes that large oil companies are greedy companies or don't care, but that is not the case in BP. We care about the small people.
BP chair. Chairman Carl Henrik Svanberg issuing an apology, saying that they have expressing sadness and sorrow, as well as reiterating what we heard from the president regarding this escrow. Let's bring in Chuck Thomas.